Brajabaranagara Gokula Ranjana Kana Yasamati Nandana Brajabaranagara Gokula Ranjana Kana Koki parana dhanna madhana manohara
Koki parana dhanna madhana manohara
Koki parana dhanna madhana manohara
Koki parana dhanna manohara
Kalyadamana vidhana
Kalyadamana vidhana
Kalyadamana vidhana
Kalyadamana vidhana
Amala Harinam Amya Vilasa
Amala Harinam Amya Vilasa
Amala Harinam Amya Vilasa
Amala Harinam Amya Vilasa
Vipina Puran Dharana Vinna Nagara Bara
Vinna Purandara Vinna Nagara Bara
Vipina Purandara Vinna Nagara Bara
Vinna Vinna
Vamsi Badana Suvasa
Vamsi Badana Suvasa
Vamsi Badana Suvasa
Vamsi Badana Suvasa
Braja Janapalana Asurakulana Shana Braja Janna Palana Surakula Nashana Nanda Godana Rakohala
Nanda Godana Rakohala
Nanda Godana Rakohala
Nanda Godana
Govinda Madhava Navanita Taskara Govinda Madhava Navanita Taskara
Govinda Madhava Navanita Taskara
Sundara Nanda Gopala
Sundara Nanda Gopala
Sundarananda Gopala
Sundarananda Gopala
Yamuna Tatachara Gopi Vasanahara
Yamuna Tatachara Gopi Vasanahara
Yamuna tatachara gopi vasanahara
Yamuna tatachara gopi vasanahara
Rasa rasika kripa moya
Rasa rasika kripa moya
Rasa rasika kripa moya
Rasa rasika kripa moya
Shri Radha Balabha Vrindavana Natabara
Shri Radha Balabha Vrindavana Natabara
Shri Radha Balabha Vrindavana Natabara
Shri Radha Balabha
Bhakti Vinoda Shraya
Bhakti Vinoda Shraya
Amala Harinam Hamya Vilasa
Amala Harinam Hamya Vilasa
Govinda Madhava Navanita Taskara Shri Radha Balava Vrindavana Natabara Bhakti Vinoda Shraya Bhakti Vinoda Shraya Jai Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari
Jai Radha Madhava
Kunja Bihari
Jai Radha
Jana Bala Bhagiri Bharatari
Gopi Jana Bala Bhagiri Bharatari
Gopi Jana Bala Bhagiri Bharatari Yashoda Nandana Praja Janaranjana
Yashoda Nandana Praja Janaranjana
Yashoda Nandana Praja Janaranjana
Yashoda Nandana Praja Janaranjana
Yamuna Tira Vanachari Yamuna Tira Vanachari
Yamuna Tira Vanachari
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama 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 Hari Hari
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hari Hare Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hari
Go Premanande Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya.
Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya.
Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya.
Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya.
Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya.
Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya.
Narayanam namaskrityam.
Narayanam namaskrityam.
Naram chaiva narottamam.
Naram chaiva narottamam.
Devim sarasatim vyasam.
Devim sarasatim vyasam.
Tato jayamudiraya.
Tato jayamudiraya.
Nasta praeshu vabhadreshu.
Nasta praeshu vabhadreshu.
Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya.
Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya.
Bhagavati Uttama Shloke.
Uttama Shloke.
Bhaktir Bhavati Naishtiki.
Bhakti Bhavati Naishtiki.
We're reading Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 1, Chapter 3, Text Number 28.
Bhajavatam, 第一篇, 第三章28节.
Ete chamsa kalapumsa.
Ete chamsa kalapumsa.
Ete chamsa kalapumsa.
Ete chamsa kalapumsa.
Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam.
Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam.
Indrari Vyakulam Lokam.
Indrari Vyakulam Lokam.
Mridayanti Yoge Yoge.
Mridayanti Yoge Yoge.
Mridayanti Yoge Yoge.
Mridayanti Yoge Yoge.
Ete chamsa kalapumsa.
Ete chamsa kalapumsa.
Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam.
Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam.
Indrari Vyakulam Lokam.
Indrari Vyakulam Lokam.
Mridayanti yoge yoge.
Mridayanti yoge yoge.
Ete chamsa kalapumsa.
Ete chamsa kalapumsa.
Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam.
Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam.
Indrari Vyakulam Lokam.
Indrari Vyakulam Lokam.
Mridayanti yoge yoge.
Mridayanti yoge. Yoge yoge. Iti tamsa kala pumsa.
Iti tamsa kala pumsa.
Mridayanti yoge yoge.
Iti tamsa kala
pumsa.
Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam.
Okay, thank you. Ete.
Mithi.
All these.
所有这些.
Cha.
Cha.
And.
And. 和.
Amsha.
Amsha.
Plenary portions.
Plenary portions. 完整扩展.
Kala.
Kala.
Portions of the plenary portion.
Portions of plenary. 完整扩展的部分.
完整扩展的部分.
Pumsa. Pumsa.
Of the supreme.
Of supreme. 自尊的.
自尊的.
Krishna.
Krishna.
Lord Krishna.
Lord Krishna.
主 Krishna.
主 Krishna.
To.
To.
But.
But. 但是.
Bhagavan,
Bhagavan,
the personality of Godhead,
personality, 亲自, 本人,
Indra Ari, the enemies of Indra, Vyakulam, disturbed,
disturbed, 被打扰,
Lokam,
Lokam,
all the planets,
all the planets, 所有星球,
Mridayanti,
Mridayanti
gives protection.
Gave protection. 给予保护.
Yuge, yuge,
yuge, yuge.
In different ages.
In different. 在不同的年代.
Translation. All of the above mentioned incarnations are either plenary portions or portions of the plenary portion of the Lord. But Lord Sri Krishna is the original personality of Godhead. All of them appear on planets whenever there is a disturbance created by the atheists. The Lord incarnates to protect the theists.
译文上面提到的所有化身，要么是自尊主的完整扩展，要么是完整扩展的部分。但其中的圣主 Krishna 却是存在中的第一位人格首身。每当无神论者制造混乱时，自尊主的这些化身就降临不同的星球，保护有神论者。Purport
by Srila Prabhupada. In this particular stanza, Lord Sri Krishna, the personality of Godhead, is distinguished from other incarnations. He is counted amongst the avatars, incarnations, because out of his causeless mercy, the Lord descends from his transcendental abode. Avatara means one who descends. All the incarnations of the Lord, including the Lord himself, descend to the different planets of the material world, as also in different species of life, to fulfill particular missions. Sometimes he comes himself, and sometimes his different plenary portions or parts of the plenary portions are his differentiated portions directly or indirectly empowered by him, descend to this material world to execute certain specific functions. Originally, the Lord is full of all opulences, all prowess, all fame, all beauty, all knowledge, and all renunciation. When they are partly manifested through the plenary portions or parts of the plenary portions, it should be noted that certain manifestations of his different powers are required for those particular functions. When in the room small electric bulbs are displayed, it does not mean that the electric powerhouse is limited by the small bulb. The same powerhouse can supply power to operate large-scale industrial dynamos with greater volts. Similarly, the incarnations of the Lord display limited powers because so much power is needed at that particular time. For example, Lord Parasaram and Lord Narasimha displayed unusual opulence by killing the disobedient Kshatriyas 21 times and killing the greatly powerful atheist Hiranyakashipu. Hiranyakashipu was so powerful that even the demigods in other planets would tremble simply by the unfavorable raising of his eyebrow. The demigods in the higher level of material existence many, many times excel the most well-to-do human beings in duration of life, beauty, wealth, paraphernalia, and all other respects. Still, they were afraid of Hiranyakashipu. Thus, we can simply imagine how powerful Hiranyakashipu was in this material world. But even Hiranyakashipu was cut into small pieces by the nails of Lord Narasimha. This means that anyone materially powerful cannot stand the strength of the Lord's nails. Similarly, Jamadagni displayed the Lord's power to kill all the disobedient kings powerfully situated in their respective states. The Lord's empowered incarnation Narad and plenary incarnation Varaha, as well as indirectly empowered Lord Buddha, created faith in the mass of people. The incarnations of Rama and Dhanvantari displayed his fame, and Balaram, Mohini, and Vamana exhibited his beauty. Dattatreya, Matsya, Korma, and Kapila exhibited his transcendental knowledge. Nara and Narayan rishis exhibited his renunciation. So all the different indirectly are directly empowered incarnations of the Lord manifested different features. But Lord Krishna, the primeval Lord, the complete features of Godhead. And thus it is confirmed that he is the source of all other incarnations. And the most extraordinary feature exhibited by Lord Sri Krishna was his internal energetic manifestation of his pastimes with the cowherd girls. His pastimes with the gopis are all displays of transcendental existence, bliss, and knowledge. Although these are manifested temporarily into the material life. Although these are manifested apparently as sex love, the specific attraction of his pastimes with the gopis should never be misunderstood. The Bhagavatam relates his transcendental pastimes in the 10th canto, and in order to reach the position of understanding the transcendental nature of Lord Krishna's pastimes with the gopis, the Bhagavatam promotes the student gradually in 9 other cantos. According to Srila Jiva Goswami's statement, in accordance with authoritative sources, Lord Krishna is the source of all other incarnations. It is not that Lord Krishna has any source of incarnation. All the symptoms of the Supreme Truth in full are present in the person of Lord Sri Krishna. And in the Bhagavad Gita, the Lord emphatically declares that there is no truth greater than or equal to himself. In this stanza, the word Swayam is particularly mentioned to confirm that Lord Krishna has no other source than himself. Although in other places the incarnations are described as Bhagavan because of their specific functions, nowhere are they declared to be the Supreme Personality. In this stanza, the word Swayam signifies the supremacy as the Saman Bonum. The Saman Bonum is one without a second. He himself has expanded himself in various parts, portions, and particles as Swayam Rupa, Swayam Prakash, Tadekatma, Prabhav, Vaibhav, Vilas, Avatar, Avesha, and Jivas, all provided with innumerable energies just suitable to the respective persons and personalities. Learned scholars in transcendental subjects have carefully analyzed the Saman Bonum. Krishna to have 64 principal attributes. All the expansions or categories of the Lord possess only some percentages of these attributes. But Sri Krishna is the possessor of the attribute 100%. And his personal expansions, such as Swayam Prakash and Tad Ekatma, up to the category of the avatars, who are all Vishnu Tattva, possess up to 93% of these transcendental attributes. Lord Shiva, who is neither avatar nor avesha, nor in between them, possesses almost 84% of the attributes. But the jivas, or the individual living beings in different stanzas of life, or statuses of life, possess up to the limit of 78% of the attributes. In the conditioned state of material existence, the living being possesses these attributes in very minute quantities, varying in terms of the pious life of the living being. The most perfect of living beings is Brahma, the supreme administrator of one universe. He possesses 78% of the attributes in full. All other demigods have the same attributes in less quantity, whereas human beings possess the attributes in very minute quantity. The standard of perfection for a human being is to develop the attributes up to 78% in full. The living being can never possess attributes like Lord, like Shiva, Vishnu, or Lord Krishna. A living being can become godly by developing the 78% transcendental attributes in fullness, but he can never become a god like Shiva, Krishna, or Vishnu. He can become a Brahma in due course. The godly living beings who are all residents of the planets in the spiritual sky are eternal associates of God in different spiritual planets called Haridham and Maheshdham. The abode of Lord Krishna above all spiritual planets is called Krishna Loka or Goloka Vrindavan. And the perfected living beings, by developing 78% of the above attributes in fullness, can enter the planet of Krishna Loka after leaving the present material body.
虚拟泡泡药子这件事把人格守成圣主奎桑与他其他的化身做了区别之所以把他算作阿瓦塔尔的名单中是因为他出于没有缘故的仁慈从他超人的居所降临到物质世界梵文阿瓦塔尔的意思是降临者至尊主所有的化身包括至尊主本人为了实现特定的目的会降临到物质世界内不同的星球上以及不同的物种中
他有时亲自前来，有时候则让他不同的完整扩展或完整扩展的部分，以及他直接或间接赐予的力量的化身来到这个物质世界，完成特定的使命。至尊主本人绝对拥有一切财富、力量、名望、美丽、知识和气绝。我们应该注意，当他的完整扩展或完整扩展的部分扩展展示他的各种财富时，意味着当时他要完成他们各自的使命，只需要展示那么多的力量。一个房间里亮的一盏小电灯，并不意味着整个发电厂要受小电灯泡的限制。同时，尽管如此，他们还是惧怕 Hiranyakashipu。因此，我们可以想象一下 Hiranyakashipu 在这个物质世界里有多么的强大。然而，他却被主尼金哈的指甲撕成了碎片。这意味着，任何在物质上强有力的生物体，一旦面对至尊主的指甲，就变得不堪一击。同样，帕拉苏拉玛通过杀死那些在各个国家中建立了强大政权的国王们，展现了至尊主的力量。至尊主授予了力量化身纳拉达和完整扩展化身瓦拉哈，以及被间接授予了力量的佛祖，在不同的人群中建立信心。化身拉玛和丹文塔瑞展现至尊主的名望，巴拉拉玛、摩黑尼和瓦玛纳展现了他的美丽。达塔崔亚、玛奇亚、库尔玛兄弟和卡皮拉展现了他拥有的超然知识，而纳尔达和纳拉瑞西则展现了他的气绝。尽管至尊主所有这些化身直接或间接地展现了他的不同特质，但至尊主奎萨本人却展示了守神的完整特质。正因为如此，经典证实奎萨是所有其他化身的源头。圣主奎萨所展示的最非凡的特质是他的内在能量所展现的他与牧牛姑娘的娱乐逍遥。他与牧牛姑娘的逍遥活动虽然表面上看起来像是异性间的爱，但实际上是超然存在、极乐和知识的全部展现。他与牧牛姑娘的逍遥活动所具有的特殊魅力永远都不应该遭到误解。徐曼巴格瓦坦在第十篇中讲述了这些超然的娱乐活动。为了让学习徐曼巴格瓦坦的人能正确地理解主奎萨与牧牛姑娘的逍遥活动的超然本性，徐曼巴格瓦坦用前九篇铸剑提升他的学生。所以吉瓦格索阿米引经据典及前辈灵性导师的权威阐述说明，主奎萨是所有其他化身的始源，而不是还有着其他源头的化身。最高真理所具有的一切真相全部体现在主奎萨身上。在巴格瓦吉塔中，至尊主明确声明，没有比他更高或与他平等的真理了。这节诗中专门用梵文本人斯瓦样一词来证实，主奎萨本人就是一切的源头，除了他本人，再也没有其他的源头了。尽管至尊主的众多化身因他们所起的特殊作用，而在经典的其他地方被称为巴格旺、博加范，但没有一个地方称他们为至尊者。然而，这节诗中的梵文本人一词表明了主奎萨作为至善的最高地位。奎萨作为至善是独一无二的，他本人 Svayam Rup 展示出为被称为 Svayam Prakash， 他的 Ekatma， Prabha Vibha Vilas Avatar Avesa 和 Jiva 等多种部分完整扩展及威力，并提供无数的能量，以适合这些人物的身份及所从事活动的需要。在超然知识领域中的学识渊博的学生们仔细分析至尊至善奎萨后得出结论，说他有64种主要的特性。至尊主奎萨的每一个扩展都是拥有他这些特性中的一部分，但圣奎萨本人100%的拥有所有这些特性。斯瓦扬帕卡斯、埃德埃特玛、帕巴夫等他本人的扩展，直到阿瓦塔尔范畴，都属于维斯诺塔特瓦，都能拥有最多达到93%的这些超然特性。希瓦既不是阿瓦塔尔，也不是阿维沙，也78%。在物质存在受制约的状态中，生物体根据他们所从事的各种前程活动，而不同从众的微量拥有那78%的特性。在每一个物质宇宙中，最完美的生物体是宇宙的最高管理者 Brahma， 他全部拥有那78%的特性。所有其他半神人也拥有同样种类的特性，但在量上比 Brahma 少。普通人类只微量拥有这些特性，能拥有像 Shiva、Vishnu 和至尊主 Krishna 那样多的超然特性。个体生物可以请求分别称为 Haridam、Mahishadam、 至尊主 Krishna 居住的地方在所有其他灵性修求之上，称为 Krishna Loka 和 Goloka Vrindavan。靠完全发展出上述超然特性中的78%的特性而变得完美的生物，可以在离开现有的物质躯体后进入称为
昆明利达涅那Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhaye Vacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shivasade Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama。
这是盛典薄伽晚坛中最 重要的诗节之一。
The Lord Krishna is shown to be different from the other incarnations。
这里把 Krishna 和其他的化身区别开来。
The difference being that Lord KrishnaIs the source of all the incarnations.
那指出 Krishna 是所有化身的源头。
But at the same time, Lord Krishna also comes into this world.
但同时 ，Krishna 本人也亲自来到这个物质世界。
So Lord Krishna is both an incarnation and at the same time he's the source of all the incarnations.
所以呢 ，Krishna 既是化身，又是所有化身的源头。
And Srila Prabhupada explains how Lord Krishna takes many different forms in order to fulfill different missions.
所以泡泡在这里提到了 Krishna 如何化身为不同Krishna 以不同的化身来执行他不同的功能。
Just like when there was a flood and all the planets were flooded, at that time the Lord took the form of a fish.
就像比如这个当这个星球被洪水淹没的时候 Krishna 就化身为鱼前来。
And he was able to help Satyavrata, a devotee, to save the Vedas.
然后就他展示了如何拯救他的奉献者 Satyavrata 和那些Satyavrata 奉献者和 and?
To save the Vedas.
拯救伟达经。
Right, so Lord Krishna took the form of Matsya, the Matsya avatar.
So Krishna 化身为 Matsya, 化身一条鱼。
And then he took the form of Kurma, as in the demons were churning the ocean of milk.
这个恶魔和半身人搅。
To churn the ocean.
他们用这个山来搅拌这个海洋。
But nobody could, the demigods and demons were not able to support the mountain.
但是那个半身恶魔没法支撑这个山。
Therefore, the Lord took the form of the Kurma, the turtle, and had the mountain rest on his back.
然后呢，这个 Krishna 就化身为一个乌龟，这个 Kurma, 然后把这个山放到自己的背上。
Yeah.And when the earth fell into the bottom of the Garbhodak ocean, at that time the Lord took the form of Varaha.
当这个地球跌落到蕴难之洋底部的时候，这个灰山就化身为雄主瓦拉哈。
Because the boar could go dive into the bottom of the ocean and pick up something from the dirty place.
因为这个猪啊。到这个蕴当之洋的底部，他实际上去了一个比较脏的地方。
Of course, when the Lord takes the form of these different creatures, He will perform inconceivable, wonderful activity.
当然了 ，Krishna 以这种不同的这个生物的形象来，他在行使的那种不同美妙的那种逍遥活动。
And He is never an ordinary.Living entity
来展示它是不同非同寻常的生物。
He may take the form of a boar, but he's a gigantic boar.
他化身为猪，但这个猪的形象特别庞大。
And his appearance was very wonderful.
看起来也特别的美妙奇妙。
Lord Boar took birth from the nostril of Brahma.
这个雄猪呢，是从 Brahma 的鼻孔中出来的。
So this was inconceivable.
这就本身就让人不可思议了。
Could you give birth to a child from your nostril?
有谁从鼻孔中生孩子的吗？谁从鼻孔中把孩子给 生出来了？
But Lord Varaha appeared from the nostril of...
那瓦拉哈就从鼻孔中生出来了。
And Lord Nrisingadeva appeared from the pillar.
尼辛哈是从那个柱子那里边 出来的。
You want to... Could you ever see any living entity come from the pillar?
大家谁看到了那个谁从哪个生物从柱子里出来的？
Then he assumes a wonderful form, half man, half lion.
然后出来后吧，还有一个美妙的形象，半人半狮。
Would you like a child, half man, half lion?
你希望你的孩子是半人半狮的形象吗？一半像人，一半像狮，是你希望你的孩子那样吗？
This is the wonderful pastimes of the Lord, that he can assume all of these different forms.
所以这就是主的以不同形象展示的这种奇妙的这个活动。
To perform wonderful activities.
是为了展示美妙的活动。
And then he came to help the demigods get back the heavenly planet.
所以他显现就帮助半神人夺回这个天堂。
At that time he took the form of a dwarf Brahmana.
就为了帮助半神人夺回天堂，他就化身为侏儒 Vamana。
You will like your child to grow big and tall. You will, if you have a child, you will want the child to grow tall.
如果你有孩子的话，你希望你的孩子长得又高又壮。
But Vamana, Lord Vamana was a dwarf.
但是主 Vamana 他长不大，就是个侏儒，就这么孩子侏儒。
But he has come.To perform a wonderful pastime.
但是他来吧，还展示奇妙的逍遥活动。
So these are the different. The Lord appears, of course, in many, many different forms.
所以主来啊，展示了不同的形象。
There's the swan incarnation.
有天鹅的化身。
There's the horse incarnation.
有马的化身。
There's one time, one man came to Srila Prabhupada Sadhu.And he came to Srila Prabhupada and he said, "Ask Prabhupada, can I ask you a question?"
对，从刚从前有一个人来找 Prabhupada， 这个人是个圣人，来到了 Prabhupada 问，就跟 Prabhupada 说，我说阿米蒂，我能问你一个问题吗？
So Prabhupada said to the man, "All right, ask Prabhupada, can God be in a snake?"
好，问的是，主可不可以变成一条蛇？
And Prabhupada said, "Yes, he can."
泡泡说可以啊，主可以变成一条蛇。
Just like we know, when the demigods and the demons had to churn the ocean of nectar, they took the celestial serpent to churn the ocean.
就像半神恶魔搅拌那个牛奶之羊的时候，他们把一条蛇当做那个搅拌棍。
And Lord Ananta Shesha.Is also in the form of a serpent.
主的那个Ananta Shesha的形象就是蛇，蛇的形象。
Lord Ananta Shesha acts as a bed, a couch for the Lord.
对这个Ananta的职责就是承载的驮着这个主。
When the Lord wants to lay down, he can rest on the body of Ananta Shesha.
如果主想躺下的时候，就躺在那个蛇床上。
So the Lord appears in so many different species.
所以主呢，在不同的种族中显现。
And we see also the Lord's devotees also are there in different species.
我们也看到主的奉献者也存在于不同的种族中。
Just like Hanuman is a monkey.
就像 Hanuman 是一只猴子。
And Garuda is a bird.
Garuda 是一只鸟。
So many different forms. They can be the Lord can come and his devotees can also come.
所以主啊，在不同的形体中来，奉献者也以不同的形体种族来。
But Prabhupada makes the point that when the Lord's incarnations come, they don't all display the full power of the Supreme Lord.
但泡泡这里说，主的化身来，并不是说他有主的所有的力量。
Just like here, we have some electric light bulbs.
就在这里，我们看上面有小灯泡。
So the power which is used to light the light bulbs. this is only a portion of the power coming from the power station.
这个我们这灯泡已经亮了灯，你都知道，这些只是来自于发电厂的一部分的能量。
Right, the power station can provide enough electricity to light the whole of Hong Kong.
那你大家知道，这个发电厂的供电是给所有的香港的供电的。
Everywhere there's so many moving pull you along.
你看你在走在路上所经过的那些都大屏幕不断闪的那个电影那个。
And there are lifts everywhere taking people up and down.
到处都有。
From the powerhouse.
而这些都是发电厂中的碎片部分。
And Prabhupada says, Lord Nrsingadev just killed one demon.
所以这里Prabhupada提到了，可以说卡西布杀了一个恶魔。
No.Nrsingha 杀了一个。
尼辛哈德武杀死了一个恶魔。
Right, the demon was Hiranyakashipu.
那恶魔是 Hiranyakashipu。
Right, Lord Nrsingadev killed the demon.
主尼辛哈杀死了一个恶魔。
But that demon was so powerful that all the demigods were afraid of him.
这恶魔是这么有力量，连半神人都对他特别的害怕。
And Parasurama.He killed the Kshatriyas, the Kshatriya dynasty, killed the Kshatriyas 21 times.
这个 Parasurama 杀的那国王恶魔杀了21次。
And after he'd done all the killing, then he had to go and do tapasya, deaths.
因为他知道他要对这么多的死亡负有责任，作战，自己不打。
And then Prabhupada talks about Parasurama's father.Jamadagni. There was one king called Jamadagni.
有一个国王叫 Jamadagni, 是 Parasurama 的父亲。
And he killed he also killed a lot of Kshatriyas.
所以他也杀了很多的 Kshatriya, 沙地利。
So the power to do these different things, it comes from the Lord.
而这些做这些活动的力量来自于主。
And then Prabhupada talks about how Lord Buddha inspired faith in people.
这里 Prabhupada 也描述了这个佛祖啊，激励那些无神论、无信仰的人。
People, ordinary people, they had no faith in anything, but they had developed faith in the Buddha.
而这些无神论的人呢，对什么都没信心，但是他们对佛祖特别有信心。
And they followed him.
所以这些人追随了佛祖。
And then, so many different features. The Prabhupada discusses many different incarnations of the Lord.
所以Prabhupada解释了主的不同的化身。
And he says they're all empowered.By the Supreme Lord.
他解释说，所有这些化身力量都是由至尊主赐予的。
And you want to, we can see different features in different incarnations.
人们看到这个不同的化身有不同的特色。
The Prabhupada talks about how the Mohini Murti was very beautiful.
爸爸在这里说，他的化身摩黑尼是多么的美丽。
And Balarama also was very handsome.
这个巴拉拉玛也特别的英俊潇洒。
Lord Rama is very famous.
而这个 Rama 最有名，可有名了。
Even today, Lord Rama is very famous.
直到现在 ，Rama 也特别的有名气。
They built the big temple in the birthplace of Lord Rama.
在主 Rama 的出生地，他们建了一个庞大的庙。
And thousands and thousands of people go to see the deity there.
成千上万的人都去那个庙看神像。
And more and more people are reading Ramayana now.
现在越来越很多很多的人都在读那个 Ramayana, Rama 的漫游。
So Lord Rama is very famous.
所以这个 Rama 特别有名。
And then Prabhupada talks about Lord Kapila. He gave special transcendental knowledge.
然后Prabhupada提到了 Kapila, 他赐予了特殊的超然知识。
And the Nara Narayan Rishis, they were doing their tapasya.
提到了 Nara Narayana Rishi, 他们做 tapasya 苦行。
So different features, different opulences were displayed by different incarnations.
所以不同的化身展示了不同的力量，不同的那个福。
But it's Lord Krishna who's the source of all these different powers.
而 Krishna 是所有这些不同力量的源头。
And we see in Lord Krishna all the symptoms, all the powers, all the opulences are there.
而在 Krishna 展示了所有的富裕、所有的力量、所有的属性，全在 Krishna 一个人身上展示出来。
But where Prabhupada points out the most wonderful thing.About Lord Krishna is his pastimes with the gopis.
而泡帕说了，这个 Krishna 展示的最著名的那个逍遥活动，就是与牧牛姑娘、狗皮们的这个逍遥时光。
This is the internal potency of the Lord.
这是主的内在能量的使然。
So, these pastimes, of course, with the gopis, they're described in the 10th canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam.
当然了 ,Krishna 跟牧牛姑娘的逍遥活动在圣典伯加瓦坛第十篇才有描述。
Because until you go through the first 9 cantos, you're not really qualified to understand the pastimes of Krishna.
当然如果你不经过前九篇的阅读的话，你是很难有资格去直接了解第十篇的逍遥活动。
We have to hear about Lord Krishna, how he does the creation.
我们得了解 Krishna 是怎么创造的。
How Lord Krishna is producing so many universes.
所以看 Krishna 如何制造了整个这么多的宇宙。
And how he's arranging for the administration of these different universes.
然后他在这个不同的宇宙中是怎么管理、怎么安排的。
And when we understand how Lord Krishna has inconceivable potencies,Then we can try to understand his pastimes with the cowherd girls.
当我们明白了这些主的不可思议的这个力量之后，我们才能够了解 Krishna 和这些狗皮牧牛姑娘的这些逍遥活动。
But until we understand his inconceivable potency, we will never understand his pastimes.
否则的话，你即使有这个内在能量，你也永远不会明白的。
So Lord Krishna describes that he is the absolute truth, that he is the highest truth.
所以提到了 Krishna 是绝对真理，是最高的真理。
So other persons, other different they're called Bhagavan.
其他的那个他被称为 Bhagavan,
but they're not the Swayam Bhagavan.
但他们不是 Swayam Bhagavan。
The Swayam Bhagavan is only Lord Krishna.
而这个 Swayam Bhagavan 只有是主 Krishna.
And there's no one equal to him.
没有和他平等。
So then Prabhupada talks about how Rupa Goswami, in Nectar of Devotion, he analyzed the qualities of Krishna.
所以泡巴说在奉爱的甘露中 Rupa Goswami 分析研究了 Krishna 的这个品质。
And he has listed 64 different qualities of Lord Krishna.
他列举了 Krishna 的64项不同的品质。
So of these 64 qualities, the living entities up to Lord Brahma, in their perfect stage, they could possess 50 out of the 64 qualities.
而提到了这个个体生物上到Brahma 最完美的话，也只能拥有 Krishna 的64项品质中的50项。
Right, we could have 50 out of 64 means 78%.
64分之50就等于78%。
But Lord Shiva is greater than Brahma and greater than all of us.
这个希瓦比 Brahma 更伟大，比我们都更伟大。
Prabhupada says here, Shiva is not an avatar, and he is not a Vesha either.
对，爸爸说这个希瓦既不是 avatar， 也不是 Avesha。
He is in between, and he's not in between them either, nor in between them.
What I mean, not between.
He's not.Something in the middle of avatar, you know, half avatar, half avesha.
他也不说介于这两者之间，他可能是一半 avesha， 一半avesha.
No. So we're jivas. we have it in a very perfect stage of life up to Lord Brahma, then you could have 78%.
这个我们呢是特别渺小，我们是鸡瓦，你即使达到了最好的 Brahma 那个程度，完美的程度，你也就拥有78%。
But Lord Shiva, he could have 55 out of the 64.
而西瓦能达到64项中的55项。
嗯，那55 out of 64 means 84%.
那么64分之55等于多少呢？84%。
Lord Vishnu, even Lord Vishnu is not equal to Lord Krishna. He doesn't have all the 64 qualities.
即使威士努也达不到 Krishna 那个水平，也不可能拥有64项。
Lord Vishnu will have 60 out of 64 qualities.
所以威士努拥有这64项品质中的60项。
So Lord Vishnu,It's almost God, but not quite equal to Krishna.
就是威士忒几乎跟那个神至尊神一样，但还不能达到至尊主。
Right, Lord Vishnu, something like what's it? 92% out of.
有人说他就拥有了 Krishna 那个六十项中的百分之九十三，就这样。
So Lord Vishnu, even Lord Vishnu.Although Lord Vishnu is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, He is Vishnu Tattva, He is the Supreme Lord, but He's not equal to Lord Krishna in all the qualities.
所以即使啊，这个威士忒是至尊人格首神，即使他属于这个威士忒塔塔瓦，但也不能，他也无法在所有品质上与 Krishna 平起平坐。
So.The living Prabhupada then says, we can never become God.
所以爸爸说，我们没法成为神。
And we cannot also become Shiva.
我们也成为不了 Shiva.
And we cannot become Vishnu or Krishna.
我们也更成为不了 Vishnu 和 Krishna.
But you could become a Brahma.
但是你可能会成为 Brahma.
But you have to be very, very pious.
但是你得相当的虔诚，你才能成为 Brahma。
You have to be very, very intelligent。
你得特别特别有智慧才行。
And you have to do a lot of tapasya。
你还得做大量的 tapasya 苦行，你才能成为 Brahma。
Not very easy position to take。
你要得到那个地位，可不是轻而易举的，那么容易。
But we don't want to become a Brahma。
啊
？We don't want to become。
但是我们不想成为 Brahma。
We want to go back to Godhead. To the,
我们想回归守神。
Go to the spiritual world.
我们想回灵性世界，不想回。
We just want to be an associate of Krishna.
我们想成为 Krishna 永恒的同游。
We want to go to one of the planets in the spiritual world.
我们想去灵性世界中的一个星球。
So in the spiritual world, there are many planets there.
灵性世界有很多星球。
And that whole region is called Haridam, the abode of Lord Hari.
那整个那个区域被称为 Haridam, 这个哈利的星球。
And Lord Shiva, he has his place also. If you are a devotee of Lord Shiva, you can go to Mahesh Dam.
当然，主西瓦也有自己的地盘，主西瓦的奉献者也可以去主西瓦的地方，叫 Mahesh Dam。
But if you're a devotee of Lord Krishna, you can go to Krishna Loka or Goloka Vrindavan.
如果你是 Krishna 的奉献者，你就可以去 Krishna Loka 或 Goloka Vrindavan.
But you have to develop all these qualities.
但是你得先发展出这些品质，你才能去。
You have to have the 78% of all these qualities.
你得拥有神的78%的品质，你才能去。
Then when you give up the material body.You get to go into holy name,
参诵圣名
hear about Krishna,
聆听有关 Krishna,
and we can purify our mind and senses.
然后我们就能净化感官和心意。
Any questions?
有问题吗？
没问题。
So this is a very special verse in Srimad Bhagavatam.
所以我们今天学这个诗节是圣典薄伽瓦坛一个特殊的一个诗节，特别的一个诗节。
Sutta Goswami was describing so many different avatars.
Sutta Goswami 描述了不同的化身 avatar.
And now he's talking about the Swayam Bhagavan.
然后他现在谈论了 Swayam Bhagavan.
And he said, "This is Lord Krishna."
这就是主 Krishna.
Dejam Saklapumsa, Krishna's too, Bhagavan Swayam. Lord Krishna is the Swayam Bhagavan.
Krishna is Swayam Bhagavan.
There are many people Bhagavan.
很多人都是 Bhagavan.
There are many people who claim to be Bhagavan.
有些人的自称或者不有称他为 Bhagavan.
You know, somebody has some wealth.
有些人有财富。
There's always people with more wealth.
有些人更多的财富。
But Lord Krishna has the most wealth, more than anybody else.
但是这就财富而论 ，Krishna 总比任何人多更多的财富。
Somebody is intelligent.
有的人特别有智慧。
But Lord Krishna is the supreme intelligent person.
但 Krishna 是至尊的有智慧的人。
Lord Krishna, somebody is good looking.But Lord Krishna is the most attractive person.
但有的人长得挺好看，但 Krishna 比他更好看。
Krishna never grows old.
Krishna 永远不老。
Krishna is not affected by old age or disease or death.
Krishna
is all transcendental.
他的工作、他的活动都是超然的。
It's all enjoyment for Lord Krishna.
对 Krishna 来说就是一种享乐享受。
He enjoys taking part in so many activities.
他享受参与任何的这些活动。
And we see him enjoying, he has 16,108 wives.
你看他为了享受娶了16,108个媳妇。
And every wife had 10 sons and 1 daughter.
而这个每个媳妇儿妻子有十个儿子，十个女儿。
And they were all together in Dwarka.
他们都住在 Dwarka.
And Lord Krishna was residing there, and they were all happy.
所以 Krishna 跟他们在一起，他们都开心、幸福的活着、过着。
There were no complaints.
啊
？There were no complaints.
他们居然不没有抱怨他们之间。
Sometimes demons would come.
有的时候恶魔会来
Lord Krishna would have to go and fight with them
然后 Krishna 还得出门出城和他们作战
Lord Krishna had to deal with the different enemies
所以 Krishna 还得对付应付那么多的敌人
Just like it's mentioned here in this verse that he will help also the demigods when the demons come and attack the demigods
这里又提到了当那些恶魔来攻击侵占和半神打仗的时候这个主还得来帮助半神人
The enemies of Indra mean the demons
Indra 的敌人指的就是恶魔
Right, the demons they come from the lower regions of the universe
恶魔从哪来的呢来自于地球的低等的区域
They want to conquer
他们来想征服。
They want to try to take over the universe.
他们想征服整个宇宙。
But Lord Krishna helps the demigods.
然后 Krishna 来就得帮助半神人们。
So this is his pastime.
这就是逍遥时光。
Any questions? Yes. Chitra.
感谢
妈妈讲课这世界上有很多经典我们怎么知道他们不这世界上有很多宗教宗教有不同经典我们怎么知道它经典是授权的是权威性的
Well, we say the absolute truth is there in all the scriptures.
我们看到在所有经典中都提及那个绝对真理
They will also, all the scriptures will say God is great.
所有经典都说上帝或神是伟大的
God is all powerful
而且上帝神都是有力量的
But we find in the Vedic scriptures we get the most complete information about God
但我们发现在我们的伟大的经典中他们对神和上帝的描述是最完整的
We want to know about God We want to know what does he look like
我们想知道谁是谁谁长得什么样
What where does he live?
我们都想知道神住在哪儿啊。
What does he do?
他做什么呀？
So we get all of this information in the Vedic literature.
所以我们看伟达文献提供的那个神的信息是最完整的，最全面的。
We know God is great, but we want to know how he is great.
我们都知道上帝啊，神是伟大的，但你得知道他怎么伟大。
We want to know how he creates.
我们得知道他是怎么创造的。
God is the creator, so how does he do it?
我们知道上帝神是造物主创造，他是怎么造的呢？他怎么创造的呢？
So Prabhupada compares to other scriptures, other traditions, other different religions. Their scriptures are like the small pocket dictionary. They give a brief meaning.
Prabhupada 把其他那个宗教那个经典跟我们的伟达经典比如什么呢？他们的宗教经典描述像袖珍。浓缩版、袖珍版、简易版的。
But the Vedas are like the complete dictionary.
而这个伟达经就好比是，怎么说字典叫大全大新华大字典那种。
You get complete information.
因为它提供的信息是最全面的。那是袖珍版的，其他宗教的经典，袖珍版可以揣兜里的那种。
The men in the world, like Lord Krishna too had 10 cents, but only one twatra. Is there a reason for this?
Krishna 跟每个妻子生了十个儿子，一个女儿。And then the question was?
Is there a reason for this? Why so many sons?
有没有什么原因？为什么他生十个儿子，只生一个女儿？
You get more pleasure having sons.
因为生儿子快乐更多。生儿子的快乐更舒服，更舒服。姑说，这就是原因。
You bring up girls, then it's always a problem. You have.
如果生个闺女的话，问题比较多，麻烦多点。
You have to think about getting them married.
因为你还在想将来还得出嫁呀，还得成婚呐，准备。嫁妆啊
！You have to have a dowry for them.
你还得对他很焦虑啊。
But you
嫁妆 ，yeah.
You have sons. The sons, they will get the dowry, right?
而生儿子呢，不仅不给嫁妆，还给他儿子嫁妆，捞往里捞嫁妆，生儿子还是合算。嗯。要了解有关希瓦塔的话比较困难。
Well, what can we say? Lord Shiva is a great devotee.
我们知道希瓦是伟大的奉献者。
Right, and Srimad Bhagavatam it says Vaishnavam yata Shambhu, that of all the Vaishnavas, Lord Shiva Shambhu is the greatest devotee.
在佛家网上说 Vaishnavam yata Shambhu, 在所有奉献者中，主希瓦那个桑布希瓦是最伟大的奉献者。
We always celebrate Shivratri in Mayapur at the Rajapur temple. We have a Shiva Linga and we have a big program on Shivratri.
我们每年都在马雅坡的 Rajapur 的庆祝 Shiva Ratri, 在那里我们有大的 Shiva Linga, 每年我们在那举行大的庆祝 Shiva 的活动。
Many devotees come and they will bring water and milk and Sanatana Goswami, he was a great devotee of Lord Shiva.
Sanatana Goswami 是主希瓦的一个伟大奉献者。
Lord Shiva is the master of false ego, ahankar.
主希瓦是假我的主人。
So if you have problems with your false ego, it's a good idea to take shelter of Lord Shiva.
如果你假我出现了问题，你脱避于希瓦是一个非常好的主意方法。你假我有问题的。
And a woman wants to have a good husband, she should worship Lord Shiva.
如果女子想要得到一个好丈夫的话，你最好崇拜主希瓦。
Lord Shiva is a very good husband.
因为主希瓦是优秀的丈夫。
So in the Hindu culture, the women who want to have, and I see usually when women do that, they have a very good marriage.
A good what?
I've seen that people who worship, when the woman worships Lord Shiva, they'll be happily married.
Oh, get a good man, huh?
Yeah.
我们也在印度啊，有这传统，你崇拜希瓦会得到一个好的老公。我也经常看到一些想得到优秀丈夫的那些女子崇拜希瓦都如愿以偿了。
嗯。So we have to understand that Lord Shiva has different potencies.
我们也知道主有希瓦有不同的能力能量。
Common people, they worship Lord Shiva for material desires.
一般人崇拜希瓦是为了自己的物质欲望。
They want money, they want fame.
他们想要钱。他们想要名声。
Some material thing, they worship Lord Shiva for.
为了物质事情，他们去崇拜希瓦。
So Lord Shiva, he can give these things easily.
而主希瓦很轻易的就给他们这些东西。
This is actually the cheating potency of Lord Shiva.
这是主希瓦的欺骗的骗人的能力。
That he could give something much more than all their material desires.
但是他可以给那些低等欲望中更高的东西。
But people come to him for these things. Yeah, sure. Go take.
对，一些人来找的时候，主席吧，你要啊，拿走，拿去吧，拿去吧。
Take it. Go. You want money?
拿着。你不需要钱吗？拿着，给你钱。
You want fame?
你要名声吗？给你。
You can have all these things.
这些低等东西，你都拿走。
But.The real treasure of Lord Shiva is to give knowledge of the Supreme Lord.
而主希瓦拥有的最价值连城的东西什么呢？有关主的知识。
The Lord Shiva also, there's a line, but there's a line of disciplic succession also coming from Lord Shiva.
所以有一个传系，这个传系来自于主希瓦。
And people who are more thoughtful, they will think, what is the most valuable thing we can get?
然后有智慧的人深思熟虑的人他会想我从希瓦那里得到应该最有价的东西应该是什么、
yeah, there's a pastime that Sanatana Goswami he was approached by one man that he heard that this Sanatana Goswami he's got a valuable stone a touchstone which can change things to gold
有一个故事呢就是有一个人接近了 Sanatana Goswami他知道 Sanatana Goswami 有一个价值连城的石头，就点击石，能够把任何东西转变成黄金。
So the Brahmana the man came to Lord Shiva and he to Sanatana Goswami. He came to Sanatana Goswami and he asked him. He said, "I heard you've got a touchstone, a Chintamani stone. Can you give it to me?"
然后这男人就找到 Sanatana Goswami 说：“我听说你有一个 Chintamani 点击石，能不能把点击石送给我呀？”
And Sanatan said, "Oh yeah, you want that? It's over there with all the garbage over there."
好了 ，Sanatan 哥算说你需要吗？好啊，你去拿吧，我把它放在垃圾堆里了。
So the man went over there and he got the stone and he saw it was touching, it was changing things to gold. He was very happy.
然后这个人就到垃圾堆里找到那个点击石，然后一点，什么都变成黄金。这个人高兴坏了。
But then he thought more about it and he thought, well.Why is doing like that? He doesn't take care of it. So valuable.
然后这个人就特别有点智慧，有点头脑。这么好的东西怎么放也不小心的照看，扔在那个地方。
He understood that Sanatan, you must have something more valuable than this.
然后他对 Sanatan 说嘛 ，Sanatan， 你肯定有比这更有价值的东西没给我。
And Sanatan said, Yeah, I do. I have something much more valuable.
然后 Sanatana 说：“是的，我还有比点金石更有价值的东西没给你。”
So then he said, "Why don't you give me the most valuable thing?"
请把最有价的东西送给我吧。
Then he said, "First, you have to throw that stone away."
可以呀，首先把点金石给我扔掉。
Put that in the Yamuna. Throw it in the river there.
把它扔到亚莫纳河里头。
So the man thought, "Whoa."Put it in the Yamuna, I'll never find it again.
然后呢，我一旦扔到河里，再也找不着它了。 咋办呢
？Anyway, you want the most valuable thing, you have to put it in the your mind.
完了，长老说，如果你想要更有价值的东西，把点金石给我扔了，我才能给你，否则我不给你。
So he, finally, the man threw it in the Yamuna.
最后，这男人下定决心，忍痛把点金石扔到河里。
So、now give me the most valuable thing.
为了得到更有价值的东西，必须扔这个东西。
So he gave him some japa mala. He said, "Now sit here."
然后 Sanatan 给他了个 japa mala 念珠。
You sit here and chant the mala.
坐在这儿念诵，这是最有价值的东西。
So this way, the man got the most valuable thing.
所以这个男人最后得到了最有价值的、价值连城的东西。
So Lord Shiva is like that.
主希瓦就像这样。
He will give the he will cheat people. He will give them material wealth.
他可以骗人，给他物质财富来骗你。
He won't give them peace of mind.
那你想要心意的平和
？He will not give them peace of mind.
但他不会给别人那种心意的平和的。
He will just give them the material things they want.
他只是给他们想要的物质的这些欲望物质东西
No peace of mind
但这些东西不会让你心意平和
No happiness No satisfaction
不会给你满足也没有快乐幸福
But if you want the real mercy of Lord Shiva
但你想得到主希瓦真正仁慈的话
He will give you devotional service
他会给你奉爱服务的
You can readIn the Srimad Bhagavatam, the story of the Prachetas.
你可以读圣典波迦瓦塔那个 Pacheta 的这个故事吗？
那 they were sent to go and do tapasya.
他这 Pacheta 他们去做苦行 tapasya.
And they say, when you come back after tapasya, we'll get you married.
因为他们做完苦行后回来就要结婚的。
So they went to do tapasya.
所以他们结婚前他们。希瓦有很多奉献者
，But most of the common people, they just go to Lord Shiva to get material things.
但是大多数的人去找希瓦是为了物质的好处。
No, give me husband.
给我一个老公吧。
Oh, give me money.
给我钱吧。
Give me success.
给我成功吧。
So the real success is to develop Krishna bhakti.
真正的成功是发展对 Krishna 的 Bhakti 对 Krishna 的风爱
OK
As a devotee, we worship Shiva as the greatest devotee, right?
奉献者崇拜希瓦是为了要奉爱服务是吗
不是、
啊、我的
When we worship Lord Shiva, we should worship him as the greatest devotee, right?
We should worship Lord Shiva as the greatest devotee.
我们应该崇拜希瓦为伟大的奉献者，是吗
？Yeah, that's what Srimad Bhagavatam said.
是，博迦瓦坛就是这么说的。
That he is the greatest Vaishnava.
他是最伟大的 Vaishnava.
So we offer our respects to Lord Shiva.
所以我们对希瓦要尊敬有加，哦，尊敬希瓦。
Mm-hmm. Okay. Srimad Bhagavatam ki.
Jai. Jai.